Now, if we go further, we'll talk about the scanners. We'll talk about the scanners. Okay. ايش يعني سكانر؟ مين بحب يجاوب او بيعرف؟ ايش يعني سكانر؟ هاي كانت سكانر شايفينها على الشمال. عباره عن الكترونيك ديفايس، ايش بيعمل؟ كونفيرت دي ايمج انتو ديجيتال فورم. يعني ما بحولها، نفس الشيء هو مش يعني هو زيه زي الديجيتال كاميرا، لكن هو بحولها لفايل زي بي دي اف او غيره. بيختلف عن الكاميرا العاديه السي سي دي والسي اي دي، انه هنا it is required to have something like a paper or hard copy version of the image to convert into a digital form. طيب شو كمان؟ سكان ممكن يكون اشكال كثيره له، بدي هيك بسرعه نحكي عنهم. في سكانرز مانيوال، يكون هذا بالمكتبات لما تعمل سكان لصفحه. You can get something like which is called handheld scanners. Resolution اللي هو مش عالية around 100 up to 400 dpi. وبعادة بيكون يعني في distortion بالسكاني، لأنه أنت بتمسك هاي البروب أو الإيد الصغيرة وتحط على الصفحة وتعمل سكانينج بإيدك، يعني manually. فسكانينج بيكون manually، ف sometimes you need to be trained حتى تعطي good quality. طبعا هذا كلام شوي قديم، صار كاميرات تحل مشكلة بدل سكانر عن طريق الكاميرا تعملها، بس سكانر بيعطيك ميتا فايل وبإمكانك تقرأ يعني خلينا نقول التكست الموجود جوا الصفحة أو الصورة، بينما في حالة الهاي بدك أنت تاخذ كاميرا وبعدين تحولها على شيء اسمه أو سي آر أوبتيكال كاركتر ريكوجنيشن، يعني الصورة نفسها تيجي تعملها على ديفايس على سوفت وير يحول لك البارت إيمج لإيمج والبارت اللي فيها تكست زي البي دي إف اللي تقرأه مرات من اللي بيجيبوه ناس نوت بروفيشنال صوروا تصوير عادي، والبروفيشنال بيدخلوا على سوفت ويرز بتقرا الايمج لحال والتكست بيكون واضح لحال. الفلات بيت سكانرز معروفه جدا، موجوده في كل المكاتب الدنيا، بسموها فلات بيت زي المخده يعني. الريزوليشن طبعا اكيد اعلى. طبعا ايش المكون الاساسي بالسكانر من جوا سواء كان هاند هيلد او فلات بيت او اي نوع ثاني؟ هو في سكاننج بارت، يعني في عندك سكاننج بارت. شو سكانينج بارت هاي؟ انه اخذنا هيك بشكل بسيط. يعني انت عندك بكون السكانر من جوا هون مثلا في هذا المكان. في السكانينج بارت في عباره عن ايش؟ اري جويته بيتحرك فوق وتحت او شمال ويمين، مزبوط؟ هذا الاري عباره عن سي سي دي، يعني هو عباره عن سي سي دي على شكل لاين، على شكل خط مش على شكل شيب مربعه، عباره عن شكل لاين بيقرا بيعمل سكان للسطر للصفحة من أولها لآخرها. يعني هاي الفرق بين بين السي سي دي والسكانر. والسكانر عبارة عن it contains a CCD but with other one with another purpose or application. شو كمان عن سكانرز مختلفة ثانية؟ We have other scans like what? سلايد سكانر، هذا قديم شوي، كان يجيبوا اللي هو الفيلم النيجاتيف اللي كانوا يعرضوه على بروجيكتور، يدخلوه على ايش اسمه سلايد سكانر، يحول الصورة اللي مطبوعة نيجاتيف على الفيلم القديم، لا طبعا كلر بتكون عادة أو حتى جري سكيل، ويعرضوا لك إياه على البروجيكتور على على لوح معين على ورقة وعلى صفحة، فبالتالي بيكون عندنا هذا اسمه إيش؟ سلايد سكانر. شو كمان؟ في درم سكانرز، هذول السكانرز اللي بيستخدمون في في طباعة الماجازينز والجيرنالز والأشياء هاي، بيحتاجوا لسكانر يكون حجمه ضخم بتوصل فيه ريزولوشن عند 4000 6000 دي بي اي، وهذا رقم طبعا كبير جدا، دقه عاليه لانه هدفه نشر الطباعه. اذر سكانرز يعني فيري فيري كومون، يور تليفون كان يور موبايل فون كان بي يوز از سكانر. لما تقرا انت الباركود او الكيو ار كود للسوفت وير يقول لك اعمل له سكان بحيث انه يعمل له ان للسوفت وير، او الايرس سكانر اللي بيعمل سكان للعين، او حتى الفينجر برينت او فينجر سكانر اللي زي ما تشوفين هون. هذول كلهم عباره عن different types of scanners that can be used in many applications as according to the purpose and application required to have such a device. اي سؤال على سكانرز بشكل عام؟
دكتور، هلا في زي بروجيكتر بيكون زي ورقة زي الزبدة هيك زي الشفاف، بيكون مكتوب عليه أشياء بحطوها هيك بيعرضوا الإشي، هاي بعتبروه سكانر.
قصدك مش عن سلايد سكانر انت، ايش ثاني؟ ايش هو كيف بالضبط؟ ورق شفاف يعني؟
زي بيكون زي ورق الشفاف هيك زي ورق الزبدة، وبكون مكتوب عليه يعني ناس بتكون كاتبة أو راسمة أشياء أو
قصدك اللي السلايد بروجيكتر هذا، لا مش سكانر، هذا عبارة عن ديفايس قديم. يعني سلايد سكانر وهذا اللي بتحكي عنه هذول مش ديجيتال اصلا، يعني عبارة عن اشياء يعني قديمة شوي، بكون شفافيات بحطوها، بكون كاتبين عليها بطباعة بألوان أو حتى أسود وأبيض يعني عن طريق الحرق، وبحطوها على سلايدات ورا بعض يعني صفحة كاملة بتنعرض مرة واحدة.
ايوه مظبوط.
مش قصدك هيك؟ هذا راح زمان يعني، احنا لحقناه طبعا شرحنا عليه كثير. ورق بسموه ستيلس يعني، هو يعني له اسم معين هذا الورق، كأنه شفاف. هذا ما له علاقة بالديجيتال أصلا، ما له علاقة بالشغل تبعنا. هو سكانر لكنه أنالوج، سمثينج يعني أولد فاشن. هذول سكانرز بحكي عنهم كلهم ديجيتال، يعني they are reading using a CCD camera using the file or يعني reading the image and converting it into files. So we are going to use digital files. We save these يعني مثلا السكانر اللي هو تحت هذا اللي هو ال QR code، وحكينا عن ال QR code مثلا اللي هو هي هون تحت. هذا شو بيقرأ؟ هو بيقرأ هذا الكود صح؟ وفي ديكودر جويته من جوا الكود بيطلع لينك، اللينك هذا بكون اما بكون باسورد لك او بكون عباره عن لينك يو ار ال لينك للشركه، بحيث انه يعمل فيريفيكيشن او يدخلك مباشره على السايت، على الويب سايت اللي موجود فيه. هذا يسموه كيو ار كود، زي الباركود اللي موجود على الاسعار في المولز والاشياء هاي. فكل هذا بيتعامل مع ديجيتال فورمز. الان سلايد سكانر في منه انالوج في منه ديجيتال، الان هذا قديم شوي. الان بتحكي عنه انت شيء يعني صار في اعداد الماضي يعني انتهى وراح وما له بقايا الان، حد يعني ما في حد بيشتغل عليه قليلا جدا. كنا نجيب للاولاد بروجيكتر في البيت يلعبوا عليه عشان بيعرضوا عليه بكتيريا اميبا مش عارف ايش اشياء زي هيك. اما this is not a digital phone, this is not a digital scanner, but it's a scanner finally. Another type that is related to the image acquisition devices is the digital image displays. As we have seen in previous part of this session, there was a talk about the CCD cameras, CID cameras. Also, we have some discussion about the scanners and their types. Now we'll go to see or to talk about the digital image displays. So what we mean by a digital image display? In general, an image display is a device that is used to display and show an image. Now we have two types of displays. Permanent displays that produce a hard copy of an image on a paper, maybe on a film or other permanent recording medium. This includes many types of recording media. And the other type is the volatile displays. Here we produce a temporarily or a temporary image on a display screen. When we switch off the power, this display or this image that is displayed on the screen will be vanished. And this is why we call this type of displays as the volatile displays. As we have discussed in this text box, we have two types of displays. We have the first type is the, as you see here, the volatile display. The volatile display. And this includes many types of displays, the old-fashioned CRT tube, cathode ray tubes, and they are almost now out of record and out of operation because of the big development in the direction of minimization and modernization of displays. We have LCD type displays, liquid crystal displays, plasma displays. We have also LED displays, LED displays, etc. All these types are we have a very long list here, and these displays are considered as volatile displays in the sense that the produced image is temporarily saved on the screen, and when we shut down the power or we close the device, switch it off, it will this image will be vanished and will disappear. The other type of displays is the is related to the permanent displays, where we have actually here we have the printers. Different types of printers will be discussed here: inkjet printer and laser jet printers that depend on spraying or on working with the ink or injecting the ink on the paper. The other type is the thermal wax printers, or the thermal printers in general, that produce images or printing the images using thermal energy. And there's another type which is called dye sublimation printers, where we use different dyes that are sublimated on a paper with a good output quality using these types of printers. Okay, now let's go to the first type of volatile displays. These are the old fashioned of the type of these displays following the CRT type that was almost vanished nowadays. In this type of displays, we call it the plasma display. Actually, we are using millions of tiny cells filled with xenon and neon gas. In general, we have here, let's say, gas, some type of gas, and this gas is going to be charged or polarized, and it has two electrodes in a camera, in a enclosed space, and a charge will be applied to this gas in the form of two electrodes, one above and one beneath. And let's have a look on the figure on the left, on the right hand side here. As here we have two gas panels. We have this one, let's say, glass plate, and this is the other glass plate. And in between we have the gas where we have the gas xenon or maybe neon or other types of gas. Here, the gas will be charged using the electrodes at this location. Between have two electrodes, and when the charge is applied or the current is applied to the gas, it will these cells will be made to glow, and the gas emits actually light in the ultraviolet range, in the ultraviolet spectrum range that cannot be seen by the human eye. Now, to make it this visible, we coat the display from the front direction, or from front end. We coat it with phosphors. These phosphors emit light according to the ultraviolet light that is incident on it. And the phosphors are usually made by having three types of color filters. Here, the color filters are either red, green, or blue, as you see here, either blue or green or red. Okay, and when the charge, when the ultraviolet light is incident to the phosphors, it will emit light according to the strength of the incident light on it, or actually to the charge applied to this by the electrodes, and it will shiny. It will have a different color shining. Actually, when we have the combination of these three types of filters, when we combine the three parts, we'll get something like RGB colors, and this will give us a true color. This is, in general, I don't like to go in deep when discussing this issue. Now, the plasma displays are now losing their interest in the market, and very rarely can be found in the market because they consume more or less high electric power when compared with other new types of displays. Let's go further and see what we have next. Here we have the LCD crystal displays. this type is very similar to the gas type, unless we have a gas, instead of the gas, we have a liquid material. This liquid is made to be polarized. We are using a polarizing filter, and according to the polarization that is done by the filter applied by the electrodes in the liquid LCD display. If we have a look here on this on the figure, as here we have three different types of filters, RGB filters that are used to filter out three primary colors. Now, after passing the polarizer, we have a device that is made to apply to make the polarized light be let's say tinted or curved into a specific filter according to the subpixel value or subpixel let's say charge or current that is passed through this crystal. Now, when we're having three filters, we filter out three primary colors, and this will lead again to have the RGB color content. So the LCD are very similar to the plasma. Instead of using the gas in the plasma, are using the liquid that will be polarized in the LCD displays. Okay. Next, we have a more advanced, very commonly used displays is the LED, and we have now OLED, we have QLED, etc. A lot of fabrications of the LED. The basic idea of the LED, it's a light emitting diode. In general, we have, instead of having the gas inside the or the crystal inside the display, we have an LED, light emitting diode. When you apply a current, a specific current to the diode, it will emit light in the form of photons or in the shape of light. Now, if we use different colors, we can vary the light that is produced by this LED. Now, this is done actually by taking, it looks like this, the plasma in the principle of work. But in this case, instead of having the gas, we are using thin layers of organic polymers that are used when you apply a current to these polymers. Electrons give up energy as photons and it will emit light. Now, by having filters like red and green and blue, again, we can filter out three subpixels and we get the RGB color imaging, the RGB color imaging at the output. By varying the current and the voltage applied to these subpixels, we'll get any color actually in the RGB color domain, which means that we can produce true color in this situation. We have a lot of schemes and let's see, the structured devices using, manufactured devices using these types of LED displays. This is the first type of displays that produce volatile display, as we have just discussed at the beginning of this part. Next, let's go to have another look on the displays, the printers that are considered as permanent display type, where the output is printed on a paper or on a file, and it can be saved in a specific format in this case. Now, if you look at the picture on the or the animation, on the right-hand side, this is a 3D printer. This is not what we are interested with. Well, even it is very important and very interesting. However, the printer in this case, what we're talking about is the volatile display type, where we have the output either in a file or on a paper. This is the printer that we are interested with. As you see here, we have different types of printers. We have inkjet printers. There are two types of inkjet printers that deal with spraying or putting ink on the paper. We have the liquid type and the solid type. Okay. Also, we have the thermal printers that operate using thermal energy and use the thermal the temperature or thermal energy to print the image on a paper. There's a lot of types of thermal printers. However, we may distinguish two types: the laser printers that are very commonly used, and the wax printers that are used for photographic applications and in specific types of output images or output printed images. Let's go to the printer type, which is called the liquid inkjet printer. Here, whether we have a monochrome or a color liquid inkjet printer, the ink is stored in a cartridge or in a bank. In this bank, we have, let's say, either grayscale or colored images, ink. In case of the color ink, we have CMYK standard, CMY, cyan, magenta, yellow, that are stored in cartridges like these, or in, let's say, in banks. Now, by applying a specific current or voltage to the device and to this cartridge, the banks will spray ink on the paper. Now, by varying the value, or according to the coming value of the voltage or the current from the device or from the original work paper or maybe image, it will spray ink on the paper, and this ink after a while will be passed to, after passing or rotating around the drum, it will pass to a heating device that will lead to make the drying process of the ink on this paper, and the ink will be smeared on the paper before it will be dried and get out of the printer. However, the printer contains banks, and the banks contain liquid ink that is jet or sprayed on the paper to produce the output image on a paper as a permanent display device. The other type is the solid inkjet. In this case, we have the same principle of work. However, the change is the bank itself that contains, instead of ink, we have a solid ink. Actually, it looks like the lipstick of the used in makeup or female makeup, and or maybe as it, the toothpaste. It's like let's say it's solid, but it's not very hard. When this cartridge contains banks, and the banks has small nozzles. When we have or tiny nozzles, when we have the input from using a current or maybe a voltage supplier, and now it will press on the nozzles and will lead to spill some of the liquid, from the solid paste on the paper, and this will pass using a fuser roller. It will need that these ink droplets to be fixed or to be smeared on the paper, and after passing the drum, it will be applied to a heating device to make it stick to the paper surface and get a quality output image, printed image in this case. The other type of printers is the thermal wax printer. Here, instead of having banks, we have a wax ribbon. A ribbon contains three subparts: cyan, magenta, cyan, magenta, yellow. And when it has a heating head, when the current will be passed from the original image or the electronic image, it will be passed to the heater. The heater will cause that part of the ink will be diffused on the paper as a result of the heat. And this paper, after a while, will be applied to a dryer, and the dryer will be melt on the paper, and the next step will be applied to the dryer, and will lead to get the ink, the wax ink, to be fixed on the paper surface. and this will leave a dot, or maybe by repeating this process, we'll get the whole image printed on the paper and covered by wax, wax droplets, or let's say a small, let's say, it could be called also as droplets, but these droplets are not in the liquid shape, but they will be in the more or less a sort of paste or tooth, like the toothpaste or the lipstick used in, as I told you before. The other very important type of printers, the heat that use heats, or heat that use heat, is the printer type. In the printer type is the laser type of printers. In the laser type, we have high power laser. So we are going to use the laser to scan the surface of the paper. And here we drop the ink on the paper, on the drum. Now on the drum, we use a scanner. The scanner is a laser scanner that burns the small granules or the solid ink according to the current that is applied to it from the original image. And this will lead to combine the three colors, CMY, for example, for the color printing, or grayscale for one dark ink that is used in this case as a sand or as a granules. Next, after scanning or burning the ink, it will be stick to the paper, and the remaining ink that was not scanned or not was not burned enough, it will be let's say gathered or combined in some place and to be later to be removed. And the heat is, as you see, that the paper surface will be heated to high power or to high temperature, and this will lead to keep the color or the ink that was used on the surface of the paper and to be stick to it and get a color which is or a printed file or as output image that will be printed either in grayscale or maybe in color as RGB or CMY standard.